who have presented their vision in this Gargil Memorial Lecture, it puts immense pressure on me because I am not an economist. I am not as intelligent as branded or depicted by Mr. Nayak. I am a foot soldier. I am a realist. I am a person who can empathize, who can understand, who has worked on ground level, who knows what are the problems and has his own way to solve them. A person who is always open for ideas. I am not a person who feels that I know everything. Please understand my vision. Only my vision is correct. I believe in collective wisdom. I am indeed very happy and feel proud that I am speaking at this Gargil Memorial Lecture, because I feel Dhananjay Rao Gargil was not a mere economist, but he was a reformist. Not just the cooperative movement is his gift to Maharashtra and our country, but also the Gargil formula, which was mentioned earlier, which has created a place for smaller states to be competitive, to be relevant, with the income distant method, which was devised and accepted by the 11th Finance Commission and thereafter. I feel that that has made our states, smaller states, more competitive, and after this formula was accepted by the Finance Commission, you can see that the smaller states have progressed more than the bigger states. And that was also basic idea behind this formula. Maharashtra, which is one of the most progressive states of our country, which contributes around 15% to the national GDP, accounts for most of the exports, accounts for most of the FDI flow, supposed to be one of the most industrialized states, a manufacturing state. When I look at Maharashtra, I feel that the India growth story cannot become a reality unless Maharashtra growth story becomes a reality. 3 to 4 years, we have constantly seen a negative growth in agriculture sector. When I took over as a chief minister, the first challenge posed to me was, out of 40,000 villages in Maharashtra, 24,000 villages were facing worst drought, and back to back for consecutive 3 years. More than 12,000 villages faced this drought back to back 3 years. The entire rural economy devastated. And as we all know, that although in our GSDP the share of agriculture sector is 11%. It provides employment to around 45 to 50%. So this is the biggest challenge when half of your population is being employed by a sector which accounts for 11% of your GSDP and which experiences consecutive negative growth. How would you achieve the growth trajectory which is expected from a state like Maharashtra? That 40% of the big dams of entire India are in Maharashtra, and still our achieved irrigation potential is 18%. But when we look at our agriculture, what we need is water conservation, distributed water storages through which we can provide in situ moisture, we can provide moisture security to every farmer so that he can take multi crops, he can diversify not just the food basket but also the cash crops, creates an entire chain. And that's why after coming into government, I started a flagship program, Jal Yukt Shivar. Jal Yukt Shivar is a program where I want to make every single village of my state water sufficient. Every drop of water which falls down in a village is stored, is conserved, is absorbed, and it creates a moisture security for the village. And it was not an entirely new scheme. We just found out that there were 14 different schemes of water conservation which were going on in our state, but the thing was there was no convergence. So what was the result? We were offering shirt to somebody, pant to somebody, cap to somebody, wash to somebody, and nobody was well dressed. So first thing we did was the convergence of schemes, because the schemes were run by different departments. Irrigation department was there, water conservation department was there, animal husbandry department was there, agriculture department was there, micro irrigation department was there. Everybody was working in silos. We said no, let's come together. So convergence of schemes and convergence of command. I said the collector, the district collector, would be responsible for Jal Yukt Shivar, and under him, for this purpose, all the departments would converge and he will be head of all the departments. So the convergence of schemes, convergence of command, and then I supplemented it with budgetary grant. In last 5 years, we have spent on relief 8,000 crores on relief, and on agricultural investment we have spent 3,000 crores. The people's participation is amazing. Maharashtra is changing. Go to any village where this work is being carried on. In 6,000 villages, people are doing wonders. We are just helping them. And now, with the convergence, in every district,
as of now, works worth at least 150 crores have been started. And all the works are small works. Shift our farmers to micro irrigation systems, drip irrigation, where optimum use of water, which would ensure that the productivity becomes high. At the same time, in the crisis area of districts like Yavatmal and Usmanabad, we are not just providing them with water structures, but we are also providing them with electricity connection. Because not just water, if you provide just water, that would not suffice. So we are also helping them to get electric connection. You will be amazed to know that there has been a waiting list to get an agricultural connection, and the pendency is for 7 years. And our target is by 31st March of next year, there will not be a single farmer who has demanded electric connection and has not got it.
Now, Amravati, which is predominantly a cotton belt, we created MIDC there and designated it as a chemical zone. And for 15 years, not a single chemical industry came there. Not a single. Now I have made it textile zone. I have inaugurated one factory. 8 are in line. And in 1 year's time, you will find at least 5 of them operating. We are creating textile clusters from fabric to fashion, as rightly said by our Honorable Prime Minister. These clusters would make the value addition, 8 times value addition would be done in the clusters, so that our farmers would be benefited. On one hand, this is an initiative where I want to revive my agri sector, and on the other side, I want to leverage on the advantage of being one of the pioneer manufacturing state. Because I feel that although we say that 45% of our employment is provided by agriculture, I know that that's not the real employment. At least 10% of the people who seem to get employment in the agri sector are actually underemployed, or they are employed just because they don't find employment elsewhere. So what is the way? In manufacturing state, we need to take this 10% of load of providing employment from agriculture to manufacturing. Physical resources, entire manufacturing base can be created here. And that's why I feel that manufacturing is one sector where in Maharashtra we need more focus. In all these visits, whosoever I have met, most of the global giants and even the people from SMEs in Germany, in China, they are eager to come to India, and they are more eager to come to Maharashtra, because they know that this is the place, this is the destination. There are so many regulations which we have put on automated route. There are certain permissions which we are trying to give in just 7 days. Entire interdepartmental massive work is going on to reduce all this permission regime and regulatory regime.